So welcome to YouTube channel, that is Makkaliga Shikshana. So in the last class we started the life process from the biology. Also we discussed about the meaning of respiration, then types of respiration, then the meaning of respiration, then how the glucose is breaking in our body in the all the three ways. One is in the absence of O2, second in the presence of O2, third in the limited supply of the oxygen. So we get the lactic acid. So all this take place in the cytoplasm as well as mitochondria. So now we can move for how the organism obtain their oxygen. Remember, we have a respiratory system. We have a respiratory system. So this respiratory system has a different organ for passage of oxygen. So we have a nose. So from that nose we have a two nostrils, then air enter the nostril, then enter the larynx, then it enters the windpipe. It enters the windpipe. After reaching the windpipe, the air flows into the a long ring like structure called a cartilaginous rings. Then it enter the bronchiole. Next, air enter the bronchi. So next, it enters the lungs. They contain the a numerous structures called alveoli. Remember, alveoli is called a structural and a functional unit of the respiratory system. They look like a bunch of grapes. These alveoli are highly supplied with the blood capillaries. So idu kenagutte blood capillaries tumba network aagi connect aagirutte. Enakke antandre capillaries ge thin wall irutte. Aa wall mukantara O2 blood olagade entry aagutte. Are tarane blood iranta CO2 olagade lungs ge entry aagutte. Idella ellu iruttappa andre, so it is in the lungs. Remember, especially human beings, they are called animals. We have a lungs for respiration. Respiration means it is the oxidative breakdown of glucose in the presence of oxygen. Means to break down the glucose we require oxygen. Remember, intake of air that contain more amount of O2 intake, then giving out of air that contain more amount of CO2, it is called breathing. It is called breathing. Remember, breathing is different from those of the respiration. Illi enagutte food athwa glucose break agutte ATP barutte. Illi enagutte andre only air in matte out agutte. Inhalation of air, now air tagontivi that contain more amount of O2. Second, exhaling air that contain more amount of CO2, it is called breathing. Next, in the respiration, air enter through the nose, then into larynx, it's also called as voice box, then windpipe, then to the we have a ear, a ring like structures, they are called cartilaginous ring. Idan madutte air continuous aagi hogodakke help madutte. These rings helpful for continuous flow of the air in our windpipe. Then we have a bronchioles. From the bronchioles they again get branching. Illa ond full tube barutte, a tube branch agutte, they are called bronchi. ಈ ಬ್ರಾಂಕೈ ದನ ಮತ್ತೆ ನ್ಯೂಮರಸ್ ಎ ಬಂಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರೇಪ್ ತರ ಕಾಣುತ್ತೆ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ವಿಯೋಲೈ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ವಿಯೋಲ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್. ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಅಲ್ವಿಯೋಲೈಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಹೆಂಗಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಸೊ ನಮ್ಮ ಹಾರ್ಟಿಂದನ ಬ್ಲಡ್ಡು ಲಂಗ್ಸಿಗೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಲಂಗ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ವಿಯೋಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಥ್ರೋ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಲರೀಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೀಚ್ ದ ಅಲ್ವಿಯೋಲೈ. This alveoli has more amount of O2. Next, inside the blood they have less amount of O2. ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, O2 ನಮ್ಮ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ನಮ್ಮ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಲರಿಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಬ್ಲಡ್ಗೆ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಹೈಯರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಟು ದ ಲೋವರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದೇ ಥರನೇ ನಮ್ಮ ಬ್ಲಡ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ CO2 ಇರುತ್ತೆ. CO2 ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬರುತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ, ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತು ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಬ್ರೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ we get energy and CO2 along with water. So this CO2 already enter the blood, and from the heart it enter the lungs and reach the alveoli. So inside the lungs means alveoli, compared to blood, blood has more CO2. That blood enter the lungs. Andre alveol mukantara blood O2 eragutte, blood ge entry agutte. Are tarane blood indana CO2 nama lungs ge entry agutte. Means inside the lungs exchange of gases takes place. That means O2 diffuse in into the blood, and from the blood diffuse into the lungs. Therefore gases exchange takes place inside the lungs. It is called exchange of gases by means of diffusion. Similarly, remember some of the organism like fishes or amphibians or maybe fishes or maybe reptiles, these are also kind of organism. They also called as vertebrates. In general, either they have a skin or maybe gills. If you take amphibia or frog, they have both lungs along with the skin. Similarly, fish, they can easily breathe through the gills. Means the organism which are found living on the land, they are called terrestrial organism. Terrestrial animals or organism, they require more amount of oxygen to produce more amount of energy that is required for maintaining constant body temperature. That's why we require more amount of O2. Adhe il tagondre either they are called what? Aquatic animals. If you take any aquatic organisms, they have or they require less amount of O2. Enikandre, because O2 also dissolved in the water, it is called dissolved oxygen. So if you take fish, they will take the water through their mouth. So inside the gills they have a capacity to trap the O2 which is dissolved in the water. So they will take the O2. Means aquatic organism, they have less amount of O2, they will draw the O2 from the water which is found in the form of dissolved oxygen. But in case of we or terrestrial animals, here they have a particular organs for passage of air or maybe O2. Similarly, we require more amount of O2 for breaking of glucose to liberate more amount of energy in the form of ATP. Then this more energy is required to maintain the constant body temperature, second for development, then growth, as well as to repair the cells. Yadadru ondu cell alli haalagide athwa damage agidre aa cells bega repair agutte. Enike andre we have a energy in the form of ATP. Similarly, increase of breathing. If we inhale the air like this, so your chest capacity will be increased. Nima chest enagutta avaga sulpa increase agutte. Then we have a rib cage, adu extend avutte orgade barutte, and diaphragm move to upward. Once you can try this like this, so easily chest will be increased. Means you will intake the air that contain more amount of O2. Next, that is called exhale. If you exhale or remove the air, so that contain more amount of CO2 and less amount of O2. Now air tagontivo athava air bidtivo adralli eradu irutte, but amount vary irutte. Now tagolanta air alli O2 jaasti irutte, CO2 thumba kadme irutte. Now bidovanta air alli CO2 jaasti irutte, O2 kadme irutte. Ee O2 illa gotappa andre namma blood alli adenagutte absorb agutte, especially from the RBC it should be absorbed, and it is transport for the cell to break down glucose inside the mitochondria. ಇದೆಲ್ಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಸೆಲ್ಲಲ್ಲೂ ಮೈಟೋಕಾಂಡ್ರಿಯಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಮೈಟೋಕಾಂಡ್ರಿಯಾಗೆ ಓ ಟು ನ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ತಗೊಂಬಂದು ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಓ ಟು ಇದೆ, ಸೊ ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಪೈರುವೇಟ್ ಆಯಿತು, ಪೈರುವೇಟ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬೈ ಬ್ರೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಲುಕೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಓ ಟು. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್, ಐದರ್ ದೇ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್, ಆರ್ ದೇ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್, or they may be ask this flow chart. So sometime they will ask this flow chart. You should remember glucose undergo splitting to form the pyruvate. Next, pyruvate in the three ways undergo splitting. One is in the absence of O2, second in the presence of O2, third in the limiting supply of the O2. Okay, so after this complete breaking of glucose, you get the energy which is stored in the form of glycogen, especially in case of where in the mitochondria of a each cell. So next we can move for another topic. So next topic is transportation. Iga already we discuss about how the food is digested and how the glucose is breakdown to liberate energy. Namge gottabeki iga ondu part inda na innondu part ge oxygen athava food yav tara move agutte anta. So in the transportation, first we discuss transportation in case of animals. Later we discuss in the transportation in case of plants also. Remember, transportation is of one of the method or a system where the food molecule from the intestine in case of animals should be transported to the cell. Enuke andre pratiyondu animals alli millions of cells irutte. So usually cell alli central nucleus irutte. Inside the cell we have a space called cytoplasm. Inside the cytoplasm we have a double layer structure, they are called mitochondria. Inside they have a finger like projections, they are called hyphae. So ee mitochondria nagutte namage energy store agutte. So for this cell we require a food, means glucose. Glucose el bandirutte by breaking of food. Food el break agirutte, complete food digested inside the small intestine. So inside the small intestine food is completely breakdown, especially carbohydrates, they give glucose. E glucose ga intestine indana pratiyondu cells ge hobeku. Enga hogutandre by means of a transportation system we have a mainly blood for transporting nutrients along with oxygen. Similarly we have a blood vessel, we have a blood vessel to transport the nutrients. Similarly we have a pumping organ, it is called heart, usually four chamber. And lastly we have another one part, it is called a lymph. So these are the some of the important parts where we can helpful for transportation of the nutrients from one part to the other part. Once again remember, when you take down the food is completely breakdown inside the stomach, inside the then small intestine. So glucose we get, this glucose is enter into blood by means of villi mukantara ee glucose enagutte namma blood entry agutte. So allinda enayitu blood mukantara na ella cells ku move aitu, yen move agide glucose move agide. So iga glucose ide, ee glucose break agodakke namage en beku, we require oxygen. So enagutte namage O2 beku, O2 linda barutte lungs. So we have a lungs. So inside the lungs I told we have a alveoli. So alveoli, from the alveoli O2 diffuse inside, and from the lungs O2 is transported to the part of the cell where they require O2 for breaking the glucose. Next O2 ide, next glucose ide break agutte, heng barutte namge, we get 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus we get energy in the form of ATP. We get 38 ATP by breaking one molecule of the glucose. One glucose break adre namge 32 ATP barutte. So next look at here, for breaking of glucose we require O2. Iga lungs inda O2 bandide, namma small intestine indana glucose villi mukanta cell ge bandide. Iga O2 ide, glucose ide, idu break agutte namge energy barutte. Ee energy mitochondria alli store agutte. So for to transport glucose as well as O2 we have a system called transportation system. It's also called as we have circulatory system that mainly includes blood, then blood vessel, then heart as well as lymph. So we can discuss the remaining parts functions in the next class. I hope you understand. Thank you.